Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you the types of distributed ledger technologies, along with a detailed comparison between blockchain, Hashgraph, directed acyclic graphs or DAG, and Holochain. So let's get started. Number one, blockchain. In the white paper that brought Bitcoin to the world, the author noted that a network would collect transaction information in blocks and other blocks would build onto each other, forming a chain of blocks. Hence, the name comes blockchain. Here, interestingly, each block produces a unique hash that identifies the transaction, and if one attempted to alter the details of the transaction, a totally different hash will be generated. This then will prove as an evidence of a corrupted or an invalid transaction, which then further will be rejected by the blockchain and will not be recorded on the block. On the other hand, the valid transactions are published on the public ledger, which every node that is participant on the network has the access to. Essentially, this distributed nature of public ledgers makes it even more difficult for parties to alter information, promoting transactions to happen under strict transparency. These qualities of transparency and immutability, or you can say integrity, are notably the major evolutionary aspects of blockchain features and is the biggest reason in blockchain disrupting many industries in the 21st century. Interestingly, blockchain is not as new a concept as we might think. The mention of its fundamental structure and operations dates back to over 27 years ago, when blockchain was invented. However, Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies cast a new light onto the groundbreaking technological innovation through their application. It is worth noting that these same cryptocurrencies created the need for solutions surrounding blockchain, which we see today, and marked the beginning of the new distributed ledger technology networks like Holochain, DAG, and Hashgraph. Also, do note that at the heart of the new networks, there lies a vision to create a highly scalable network. Further, each of these networks seek to achieve higher transaction per second capability for its sole application. Next, let's talk about Hashgraph. Now, Hashgraph is a type of distributed ledger whose foundation lies in consensus building. In particular, we all realize that DLT relies on consensus timestamping to make sure that transactions on the network agree with each other and with every node on the platform. The consensus algorithm brings out the robustness and superiority of the DLT network. Unlike the traditional DLTs, this type of DLT build achieves transaction success solely on the basis of consensus. And because of this, nodes do not have to validate the transaction that take place on the network. And as such, users do not have to present any proof of work as well. This aspect generally eliminates the need for two things. First, traditional blockchains which relied on proof of work need many computations to achieve transaction success. And as a result, this factor makes transaction bulky, which achieves very slow number of transactions per second or TPS ratio. On the contrary, Hashgraph only requires the node on the network to achieve consensus through gossip about gossip technique and virtual voting technique. Interestingly, these techniques again do not require proof of work to validate transaction, and as a result, there's little time between initiation and completion of a transaction. Subsequently, the lack of need of proof of work in the DLT network means that there can be thousands of transactions per seconds or TPS, and interestingly, the team behind Hashgraph claims that the network can achieve more than 250,000 TPS, which is quite amazing based on the current alternatives. Along with the virtual voting and gossip about gossip techniques, nodes on the Hashgraph DLT are able to experience fairness. And in particular, consensus timestamping avoids the issues of blockchain like cancelling transactions by putting them on future blocks. Next, number 3. Directed acyclic graphs or DAG. Well, Hashgraph is not the only effort to correct the limitations of blockchain. In the 21st century, developers are focusing on data structure of DLT networks that affect their efficiency. In the similar manner, directed acyclic graphs or DAG employs a different data structure that brings about more consensus into the system. In particular, DAG is a type of DLT that relies on consensus algorithm, and here consensus algorithms operate in a way that the transaction that prevails simply requires majority support within the network. In such a network, there is much more cooperation, teamwork, and nodes have equal rights too. Unlike traditional blockchain technologies where proof of work is the key, DAG ensures that there is fairness, and this kind of fairness gives the impression that the network sticks to the initial aim of distributed ledger technology, which was to democratize the internet economy. Confused on this notion? Well, For instance, a private network relies on centralized leadership, which takes out the democracy from the DLT. On the contrary, DAG gives equal significance to each and every node existing on the network. Therefore, this means that each node on the network does not have to refer to any other node on the network. Already, there are projects like Whiteboard that use DAG structure to create new generation networks free of limitations from traditional blockchain. And one of the most notable new generation networks employing the DAG structure is IOTA Tangle. Here, the miner and nodes can perform dual duties, wherein nodes in the blockchain network can perform separately. This means that a miner on Tangle can issue a transaction and validate a transaction at the same time. Number 4. Holochain. This DLT technology boasts that it is what comes after blockchain technology, and despite making such bold statements, the Holochain team really has some solid propositions that rival other platforms. In particular, Holochain is after completely revolutionizing the internet as we know it. One of the interesting visions of Holochain is to change the present structure of the internet. The internet today, as we know, is structured alongside server-client basis. This is to say that decentralization is not optimum, and further, there is little democracy and freedom regarding the utilization of the resource. In the light of this, Holochain wants to create a distributed network that can also be the basis of next generation internet. According to the platform's white paper, Holochain is an amalgamation of blockchain, BitTorrent, and GitHub. This is to say that this is a DLT that distributes power among the nodes to avoid any instance of centralized control of the flow of data. Here, a distributed platform simply implies that each node will run on a chain of its own, and further implies that nodes or miners have the freedom to operate autonomously. And that's only possible because of something the team behind Holochain claims to call as Distributed Hash Table, or DHT, in which users can store data using certain keys, and this data stays in actual locations distributed in various locations across the globe. Now, let's talk about advantages of Holochain. So, the interesting part about this data structure is that the network does not experience the burden of congestion, which is quite common in traditional blockchain. This distributedness of the location that stored data relieves the network and gives it more space for scalability. As such, transactions over this network can easily attain millions of TPS without any significant add-on cost. Further, as we all know, scalability is a huge problem that is dodging both public and the private blockchain platforms. For instance, developers usually run into huge hurdles while creating decentralized applications or dApps on traditional blockchain. This is because they need to validate a transaction from a huge community present on the platform. On the contrary, a developer on Holochain platform will only need confirmation from a single chain that makes up the whole DLT network. As such, there is an insubstantial wait time between request and confirmation in this type of distributed ledger technology. Up next, let's understand the brief difference between various distributed ledger technologies, starting with first as blockchain versus Hashgraph. So, blockchain differs from Hashgraph in quite more fundamental ways. Particularly, Hashgraph is a response to major limitation of blockchain like scalability and transaction rates. And also, do note that Hashgraph mainly differs from blockchain when it comes to consensus mechanism. On one hand, blockchain mainly relies on activities of miners within the network to facilitate the process of transactions. This is to say that a miner can greatly affect the success of a transaction single-handedly in the network. Particularly, blockchain relies on proof of work, which miners can use to verify if a transaction is genuine or not. And as such, transaction rates are already slow and quite expensive as well. Further, the proof of work implies that network comes under huge burden of bulky computation that impose network drags and sometimes failures too. On the other hand, let's see Hashgraph. Hashgraph employs consensus mechanism that does not give too much powers to miners. On the contrary, the Hashgraph uses consensus algorithms called gossip about gossip and virtual voting to decide which transaction is valid and should be added to the network. This way, the majority has a say over which transactions should go through the network. And as we already know, that in Hashgraph, there is much more fairness as compared to blockchain. Next, let's talk about blockchain versus DAG. So, in particular, the word acyclic in directed acyclic graphs, or DAG, implies that operations are strictly one-directional. Similarly, immutability is one aspect that makes blockchain popular over previously existing means of data storage. Further, both platforms operate via consensus-based system where nodes decide what happens, and as such, there is some semblance of democracy as compared to platforms that go through central command. And unfortunately, that is as far as the similarities go. Like Hashgraph, DAG fundamentally differs from blockchain when it comes to data structure. Like earlier discussed, blockchain arranges transactions in blocks such that each body of the information pertaining to a particular transaction make up a single block. Therefore, succeeding transactions result in formation of newer blocks. On the contrary, under DAG, the previous transaction has stronger relationship or influence to the succeeding transactions. And for a transaction to succeed in DAG network, it has to validate only two of the previous transactions. This is to say that a transaction will only need to ensure that two of the previous transactions do not contain conflicting information. Interestingly, this differs greatly from blockchain, where a transaction has to validate numerous transactions before being valid. Further, as blocks in blockchain multiply, it becomes increasingly difficult in terms of computation to achieve new blocks. And accordingly, mining also gets power intensive and hence expensive. On the other hand, transactions in DAG network are much more efficient as more validations happen just in case the network volume builds up. So it remains efficient even for long-term usage. Next, let's talk about the difference between blockchain and holochain. Well, as we all just learned, that holochain is some kind of revolutionary technology that seeks to turn everything on its head. And like blockchain, holochain seeks to allow secure and transparent transactions among players of the network. But many people ask, is holochain better? Well, I'll say that holochain is somewhat next level compared to blockchain. Essentially, holochain seeks to introduce a new dynamic, far different way as compared to the fundamental vision of blockchain, where blockchain seeks to decentralize transactions such that people can interact directly without the need of middle party. Holochain, on the other hand, wants to make their interactions distributed. Holochain fundamentally creates a network composed of various DLT networks, and therefore it is one of the major networks that is limitless in terms of scalability and the number of transactions user can accomplish in a second. On blockchain network, nodes rely on single network to initiate and validate transactions. And as such, as more blocks join the chain, computational burden multiplies as well as the fees associated with the transaction. On the contrary, nodes in holochain run their own chains. Therefore, there is much more room for computations to happen. The fact that each node runs its own chain in holochain implies that there is no need for miners. As such, transaction fees are almost non-existent, and further, this implies that there is no tokenization on the platform, but rather smart contracts rule the space. Hereby saying nodes running on their own chains imply that they will be able to process ledgers that solely belong to them. This way, relationship between various nodes on the network is trusted completely, and further, here, decentralized applications have infinite space to operate in, and that's why one can expect a decentralized application to operate at their optimum or the best performance at all instances. Lastly, I'd like to say that comparison of DLTs, that is blockchain versus Hashgraph versus DAG versus holochain, brings out interesting aspects of each platform. Just do note that speaking overall, it's true that all DLTs share common aspects of transparency, consensus, transactional, distributed nature, peer-to-peer, and flexibility of the network. However, huge differences emerge in the consensus mechanism and structure of the data which exist within each DLT. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.